afternoon. Welcome back to the Ask Dr. Renee Show. I am so happy that you came. First of all, we have to take care of housekeeping because, you know, I do not play when it comes to the housekeeping. Make sure, one, that you subscribe to the channel if you are not already subscribing, particularly if you are watching us not on YouTube. So make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel, Ask Dr. Renee. But please comment, like, and share. My YouTube friends, we have super chat and we have super stickers. I am answering questions and I will make sure my guest answers questions. If you please would be so kind as do a super chat. Thirdly, if you've never watched the show before, this show is here to motivate and inspire you to live the life you deserve. Because guess what? This isn't dress rehearsal, you guys. This is the only one we have. So if we don't do this right now, we're out of luck. So let's live the best lives we can right now. I do know 2020 was a rough year for many, but we don't have to do 2020 over again in 2021. We can change that. So I want to let you know some of our past guests that have shared their stories with us are Teddy Riley, D Nice, as in Club Quarantine, D Nice, Lisa Nichols, who told me that we are all meant to live an abundant life with her lovely book about abundance, Kwame, Paul Carrick Brunson, and Michelle Williams of Destiny's Child. And that's only a handful of people. We have 90 something, I think almost 100, if not 100 something interviews that have been done since the show started. We started season 7 last Saturday with the queen of my money team, Cassandra Cummings. And then today we have the coach that really helped change the whole narrative of how money is going for me, Jason Sweeting, Jay the Trader. So I need everyone to please, if you are trying to get where the money resides this year, then you want to sit down and listen to this story. And I promise you, he's going to give you an actionable step by the end of it so that you can make sure you get where the money resides, because we've already found it. Because let me tell you, his hashtag is I create ATMs. And I'm talking about ATMs as in the automatic money machines that you go and get your cash money out. So without further ado, we would like to welcome our guest, Jason Sweeting, Jay the Trader.
What's up? How you doing?
I am great. Please make sure that you, I forgot to remind you, make sure you shared with your people that we are live now. We are here.
Definitely. I went on my last story. I tell them all, like, come, you got it. I put the swipe up link, like, come on, you guys got to come in right now. It's going down.
Appreciate it.
No, I appreciate you. This is a fantastic opportunity. Thank you for allowing me the space to share.
Oh, of course. So we have to start at the first beginning, as we always say.
Not just the beginning, but the first beginning.
I like that. So, Jay, what did you want to be when you were growing up?
A football player.
Okay. You wanted to be in the NFL?
Every kid from Miami, come on. Pop Warner football was like the biggest thing you could ever do.
Okay,
you know, so every Pop Warner kid wanted to play for Southridge. Every Southridge kid wanted to play for like UM. And every UM kid wanted to play in the league. So that's what I wanted to do.
Okay, so I don't think I knew Pop Warner was a Florida thing. I do know Warner is because, you know, the movie with Ice Cube was based out of a story in Chicago, in a suburb of Chicago.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so every kid around here, like, if you're from Miami, you didn't play basketball a lot. You played football. Everybody plays football. Okay. So we all wanted to go to the league. That's what I wanted to do when I was a kid, for sure.
Okay. We have to shout out the Stiletto Bullies are in the house. I see Daisy. I see, oh, my dear friend Eva. I see Ashley. Thank you. Thank you, Ashley. So look, I'm playing with a few things, Jason. See if
it's all good. Take your time.
I don't know if it worked. I don't know. We'll see. Somebody will tell us they heard it or not. I hit something. We'll see if they heard it. But, so you wanted to play football. So,
yes.
So, did you get recruited into college, maybe?
Absolutely not. I was big when we were in elementary school and even in middle school. But somewhere around ninth grade, I stopped growing and all of my friends kept going. So and that quickly deflated my NFL dreams. I think I played like one spring semester in 10th grade. And then after that, I end up, it's funny. So I went to middle school for ninth grade because it was like a big thing. It was the last year that the school was ever going to have a ninth grade class. So all of us that came up together since sixth grade were like, bro, we're going to stay. We're not going to our high schools yet. So we did that. 10th grade, I went to this school called Coral Park. In Coral Park, I was going to play football. Play spring. And then, of course, they had this engineering program. And I've always had a math talent. So my parents, they, you know, urged me to go into this like engineering program for high school students. So I did that. And while I did that, there was this opportunity. My mom was like, yo, there's this thing going on called dual enrollment at Miami-Dade Community College, where if you're in high school, you can start your 11th grade year in high school and your freshman year in college at the same time. You should take the test. So I was like, all right, I'll take the test. And I had no idea what I was doing. So I just went in there to take the test. And when I took it, they said, hey, would you like to come to dual enrollment? So I kind of looked around at my friends as they were 6'1", 6'2", and 6'3". I looked at myself as I was a bubbling 5'10 and a half, you know, and I was like, I don't want to go to the league no way. So let's go get some free college. If I can save some money, let's go over here. So I end up doing dual enrollment. And when I graduated high school, I also had like 2 years of college.
Okay, now that's what's up. That was cool. Who knew? Fun. Okay, all these bomb bullies that are in the audience, who knew? We knew Jay was smart, but Jesus Lord, he was really smart, okay? So that's wonderful that go into college with college credits.
Yeah, yeah. It was very beneficial, you know, because it's less money my folks had to pay when I went to school. So, and it was kind of, you have like, it was a freedom too, where all of your high school friends that you know, they're like getting on the bus and trying to hurry up and get to school at 7:30. We didn't really have high school until 2:00. So depending on how your schedule, you know, if you schedule your semester classes where your first class was 12, you were home chilling until you had to go to class, you know? So you drive to campus, you know what I'm saying? You jump into your little ENC 1102 or jump into your Chem 1025 or something like that. And then you jump out of college and go to high school.
And this is our mutual friend. Look what she said.
Nerds stay winning. What's up, all my nerds? You know, it's love.
Yes, thank you, Cassandra. Folks. Thank you for watching, Cassandra.
Shout out to Big Sis. What's good?
Yes, definitely. So that is awesome. So what college did you give your talents to, as they say these days?
Well, I just went up to Gainesville to the University of Florida. They had a fantastic engineering program, and that's what I decided to pursue. You know, they had this thing called Step Up during the summertime where minority engineering students could go. We can like officially join NSBE. We can kind of learn and kind of get used to the campus. We kind of had this summer program where we visited, you know, Disney and all of these different places to see how engineering works in real life. So that was really enriching, you know, Lockheed Martin and hidden these type of places. And I did that. I promise. I went to like 3 years of University of Florida engineering. You know, I took Chem 1025, 1026, so Chem 1 and 2, Bio 1, all of the labs. I did all my maths, like Calc 1, Calc 2, Calc 3, differential equations, statics, and dynamics. And then it was crazy. I'm coming in from, so, okay, this is a bad story, but it's a good story. Check it out. So, Doc, I'm coming in from a night of adventure. Let's just say that. I'm coming in from a night of adventure and, you know, Gainesville adventure at its finest. And the sun is coming up and I'm coming in and I'm parking. I get out of my car and who do I see? I see Dr. Jonathan F.K. Earl. Dr. Jonathan F.K. Earl is a Black Jamaican man. So I'm saying that on purpose. He's Black Jamaican. His hair is white. He has maybe 9% body fat. This guy's got to be at least 70. He's a machine. He is the dean of the College of Engineering and one of the most, outside of the president and the quarterback, one of the most visible figures at the university. And I don't know if anybody knows about the University of Florida, but it ain't a whole lot of us up there. Let me just put it like that. So Black and brown folks were in the minority and he was like our chief, you know? So it was kind of like, imagine coming back to the pride and Mufasa's out for a run. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, hey, what's up? You know, how you doing? I don't want to stop you. And he really stops. And he takes his time with me. You know what I'm saying? Like he takes his time with me. And I've shaken this guy's hand once. I've watched him speak 4 or 5 times. He is distinguished, austere, really set aside. Even when he's working out, everything's all together. Like, everything's in place. So I'm like, hey, Dr. Earl, how are you? And he looks and he goes, oh, Jason. And I'm going, oh, God, he knows my name. It's not good. You know, maybe he knows that I've been adventuring instead of saying. So he said, I said, well, hey, Doc, you know. And we talked for a little while, exchanged some niceties. And he said to me this, and this changed my life forever. Imagine a black Jamaican man, white hair, totally in place, sharp as a tack. The sun is barely rising. And he looks at me and he says, Jason, we don't come to college to learn. We come to college to learn how we learn. And when we leave, that's when we start learning. I'll never forget it. We were on the corner of North South and Stadium Road, right in front of Wild Hall, the College of Engineering. He had on a white tank top, guns out, suns out. And it changed my life, because at that point I knew I wasn't just supposed to get here and stop. This was where I started. And from there, it's just been, hey, self-education, education, go learn, go grow. You know, we had this big campaign back then. Everybody's like, go Gators, go Gators. So they go write the Great American Novel, go change history, go serve your community, go Gators. And I just felt like for me, it was go time from then.
That's awesome. We're Spartans. And so we say Spartans will, because Spartans will do anything. Like, yes. First of all, I don't know how I could forget this, but last week, I had not done a show, you guys, in a long time, very long time, like since June. And so last week I started the show and I was like nervous Nelly, because, you know, Cassandra's the queen of my money team. And I'm like, Lord, I can't mess up this interview, because I knew her peeps was going to come watch. You guys, 400 views. Thank you. 400 views. Thank you so much. What a way to welcome me back. So Spartan, yeah, will get it done. But, somebody said Nesby Region 4. That's the region that we were in.
Showtime.
Yeah. Showtime. So we appreciate that shout out. But so Alicia and I were engineers too. I don't know if you knew that. So
okay,
Alicia actually graduated engineering. I transferred to physiology. I was chemical engineering. I transferred to physiology.
Kimmy?
Yes, I was Kimmy. Oh my, Alicia, do you hear this? I left that. Kept me alone, and I graduated with a great physiology degree that helped me to become a great doctor. So,
I love it.
So you graduated, Kemi?
No,
I thought you were another one like me.
after listening to Dr. Earl, it changed my life. I mustered up the courage over the next month to actually change my major. So on campus, you walk out of the College of Engineering, you go over one building, it's the College of Journalism and Communication. And what I realized is, though I had a math talent, what I really loved was problem solving, and I love communicating. I really fell in love with the idea of taking a message from one place and putting it another, and how you do that technically, like how it really can happen, and the power of messaging. So I went over there. They were like, man, we don't have any money for you. Like, what's going on? I was like, please, you got to make this happen. I want to switch because I want to be an advertising major. And so I switched my major to advertising, didn't tell my folks. So the next time that semester was over, the next time I go home, you know, everybody's coming back up. You know, we're going to like drop Jay off. You know what I'm saying? It was like a thing. I think my parents were like going to vacation or keep going. They were going to like go to Georgia or something like that. And they dropped me off. And right before they dropped me off, we go to get breakfast, because that's like a tradition. We go get breakfast. We talk about it. Then they drop me off. So there we are sitting at breakfast. And I'm like, hey, yeah, so I switched my major. Could you pass the syrup right there? you pass it, you know? And so my dad's pissed. My mom is totally upset. And she kind of gets over it in 15 minutes. He gets over it in 15 hours. But eventually they all realize that it's right where I was supposed to be. It was right where I was supposed to be. Just because you have a talent for something doesn't mean that that's where your heart is, or even where your gold might be. You know what I'm saying? You have to follow what it feels like, that passion, that drive, you know, be like water, flow with the way that it's going. And that just felt so good to leave the engineering college and go into the College of Journalism and Communication. So it was good for me.
Yeah, that is, it's very important for, you know, I don't have any children yet. I know you are a girl dad, but it's very important for parents to please listen to your children, because guess what? If they do what they love, the profits will come. If you follow your passion, the profits will come. It'll all make sense. They'll be fine. You don't have to worry about, because they love what they do. But when they're miserable, you know, life is way too short. I keep telling people to be miserable. Monday blues is a such thing. And it's literally, it's a such thing. Like, psychiatrists know about this.
That's crazy.
Monday blues. And Sunday night, they call it Sunday night something too. I forget what it's called. But, you know, because people are miserable. They're going to bed Sunday like, oh God, I got to get
up.
Right. And so I'm not, and you know, by no means am I saying entrepreneurship is for everyone. I've said that a million times. It is not for everyone because I worked harder for myself than I worked for others. And I worked pretty hard for other people. So, you know, you got, you know, it's not for everyone, but at least get a job that you love. You know, I know people in the advertising industry and, you know, especially if you're a creative, that could be a lot of fun. You know,
it's a ton of fun. Moving the messages is a ton of fun. Like, and you think about the way words galvanize. I've always thought of words. We look at Harry Potter and we call it magic, but these words, they are enchanting. They're, we call it to chant, to incant, to speak. You know what I'm saying? In Spanish, it's cantar, but we think of it as to sing. But it's like you, when you say something out of your mouth, it is invisible. No one can see what I'm saying. But imagine that an invisible thing can change a life. That is a concept. And we can, if forming the words properly, you can change a life. It's so different. Hey, girl, come here versus, excuse me, ma'am, can I have a moment of your time? Those are two different spells. One will work and the other doesn't work so well. You know, and the thing is, we're always casting spells with these powerful words that we speak. And while some might call it magic, I just call it what God gave us. You know what I'm saying? He breathed into us a powerful breath. And, you know, that's my faith tradition. No disrespect to anybody else's. But I just believe that we as people, we call it manifesting. We call it speaking things into existence. Everybody calls it a whole lot of different things, but at the end of the day, you're powerful, man. So like speak some positive stuff over yourself and just watch it happen. Just watch it occur. It's so true.
Now, Lish, I didn't even prime him. I am the queen of the secret. I am the queen of manifestation.
Yes.
People think that I talk this, you know, hallelujah, you know, they think I'm just completely loony, but I keep trying to explain to people, this is how I did it. Like, you want to know how I did it? This is how I did it. I said it a million times that it was going to happen.
Yes.
First example could be right here at YouTube. Last year, I said, we are going to monetize this channel. This year, it's going to happen. Yes. Labor Day weekend, it happened. Now, I would tell people, I only have 400 hours and you have to have 4,000. They were like, you have 400. How are you going to get to 4,000? I was like, I'll get there. Just don't worry. But it's going to happen in 2020.
Exactly. And it did.
So that's why I'm like, you gotta just keep speaking. There's all sorts of things. I'm like, I don't know how this is going to happen, but I'm going to make sure it happens. So words do have power. You've got to be careful what you say.
Yes.
Because you just never know. And if you put the right information into the universe, you know, I'm a Christian as well. My mother's a priest. Mm-hmm. You put the right things into the universe, I'm telling you, the universe will not let you down. But when I'm someone who was diagnosed with depression. I've said it before. I'll say it a million times. Mm-hmm. I understand depression and I understand how I got out. I finally stopped allowing myself to feel that way. I just stopped.
Yes.
You just got to stop. And when you stop and you start speaking positivity, it's amazing what can happen to your life.
So you have to tell
us, how did you meet the fabulous Angelica? Because I know that was in college.
So she'll tell you another story. I'm going to tell you my version. How about that? Can we go with my version now?
Yes. Okay, cool.
Here's my version. I'm with the bros. As you know, I'm a Q. I'm a man of Omega Psi Phi.
Because you know, I've already told you, my trainer who is watching, Glenn Lott, is one of your bros. And shout out, because the Qs hopefully are watching because Glenn was encouraging them to please make sure that they grab these nuggets. So go ahead.
For sure. We're to the bros and no one else. So I'm chilling with the bros, and there was this pageant on the campus. At this point, I'm back in Miami chilling with Miami Q Dogs, and we were at University of Miami. So it was a couple of ladies out there, like, they know about my talent, my ability to play piano. So in the pageant, one of the ladies wanted to sing, and she asked me to accompany her. So, of course, I was pleased. So her name is called, and you know how it goes. I go on stage first to set the stage musically before she enters or before she takes the stage. And when I come on stage, you know, the bruhs start wilding, you know, like bruhs going crazy. So what I found out, this is what she said. She said, "Who is that cute? I don't know him. Who is that cute?" So she in the audience with the cast, you know what I'm saying? She with her sorority sisters, right? So she like, "Who was that bruh?" You know what I'm saying? So she was around the bruhs. The bruhs were very full. Of course, everybody knew the bruhs. And it was like, "Oh, that's Jason." You know what I'm saying? So I played for the girl. I didn't know anything about this. Now, this part, I'm on stage. I don't know anything about this, but she plotting on me already. She already plotting. Fast forward a couple weeks. The AKAs are throwing a party at a very popular venue. Now, we have been working that venue for quite some time. In fact, everyone started using that venue because we had been, you know, the queues had been there. We were doing so many events there. So we walk up to the venue. We the bros. We, you know, so they say, you know, she's there at the table and she's like, oh, it's $5, it's $20 each. You know what I'm saying? So we look at her like, bros, we're not paying to get in here. Like, what are you talking about? So she's like, nah, you really got to pay. You know what I'm saying? So I'm looking at her like, whatever. You know, we call some people. The owner comes out. He looks at the K's at the table and is like, oh, no, they're good. They're good. They're good. So I kind of look at her like, told you. You're like, don't do that to yourself. You're going to embarrass yourself. Don't do that. Don't charge the bruhs ever in your life. So that was our second time meeting. Then there was one other time. This time she stopped me cleaning my trash, dog. I forget where I was, but I like bent over to tie my shoe. And when I looked up, it was almost like she was the only person there. I promise. I can remember, I could see it just as clear as day. It was the entrance to University of Miami coming right off US-1. When I looked up, it was like she was the only person in the world. And she was just as beautiful and lovely and wonderful. So I told her, bruhs, okay, I'm plotting on this one now. You know, like it's showtime. I don't know. Like I'm not gonna lose right now. You know, so I started losing, obviously. You know what I'm saying? It was obvious. She paid me no mind. But I was persistent. I persevered. And we exchanged information, right? And she was hanging out at her apartment one night. And I was with the bros on the yard at one of the other bros' apartments. So we just dwelling. And I get a text message. And it was like she was responding. She was like, oh, I'm home now if you wanted to come over. I immediately said, all right, y'all, I'm gone. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm gone. So I went and I promise. It was like maybe a 10-minute walk to her apartment. I get to her apartment. She doesn't let me in. In fact, she says, let's walk. And we walked around the entire campus, nonstop talking, nonstop, just intriguing conversation. She was warm and funny. She was witty. She was smart. She, you know, if I kind of crossed the edges with conversation, she was like, well, I don't really talk like that. You know, it was just so refreshing. And I'm like, yo, this girl is different. We get back to her apartment, you know, after walking around the entire campus, like literally the whole thing. And I tell her good night. You know what I'm saying? I try and give her a kiss. I think like it gently started raining. Like I promise it was like The Notebook. It like gently starts raining. Straight up. So, you know what I'm saying? Like I lean in, I give her like a little kiss, you know, and she goes back upstairs. I go back to where the bros was chilling at. And I told the bro, hey, yo, I found her, dog, and I'm good. And that was it. I promise. That was it, dog. That was it. I found her and I ain't let her go since. Nope. I found her. Nope. Ask any South Florida kid who was there that night. We was at LeBar, One Road, Capital 02. We was at Dog House. I say, dog, I found her. And that was it. I haven't talked to nobody since. Love that girl.
Amen. So now you graduate. Do you go into advertising?
Of course. So okay. I started an ad firm when I get home. I put people on retainer. It was like $1,000 or like $1,200 a month or something like that. I was doing web design. I think by that time it was just like web 2.0 and like WordPress was the hottest thing in the world. So we had people just doing websites, doing logos. There was no Fiverr. There was no Upwork. So a lot of this stuff, people really didn't know how to source talent. So I was just sourcing talent, staffing, And we did pretty good, but I, you know, it really didn't last long because I loved music. I loved music. I loved playing and singing. So I found myself letting go of the work I should be doing as an advertiser and playing more gigs and working on more records and going to more studios. And eventually I end up passing off my clients after like 2.5-3 years and just focusing on the music full time.
So tell us, where does making the band come in?
Oh, so a buddy of mine says, no, I started getting messages because I wasn't watching reality show, but back then people would, you remember when Facebook was like, oh, check your Facebook. So people were messaging me like, yo, did you see that they're doing this for like musicians? Because it was like making the band was like for singers and rappers. Right. But then he did like making his band while it was like Puff was auditioning for musicians. So I'm like, bro, this is dope. Like, I think I should go. But of course, fear and doubt are like, Jay, you're not good enough. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, yo, I don't know. So I told one of my homies, shout out to Ted. I'm like, bro, we should go together. He's like, yeah, okay, let's do it. So I buy my ticket to go. He's like, all right, I'm gonna buy my ticket. And he never did. So I think I was on like some Spirit flight for like $1.27. I'm going up. Then I, you know, I don't have but $2.25. So that's most of my money. You know, I grew up, you know, and when I get there, my friend who's he's so dope, his name is Aubrey. Aubrey Flynn tells me, you can stay with me, you can stay at the house. When you land, get a cab or get a ride, come downtown to the offices, and then you could chill here with me. So here I am, little Jay from Miami, landing at LaGuardia, and I'm looking all around. Everybody knows I'm not from here. Like, I'm like, oh, how do I get to the street? And everybody's going so fast. And I finally get to his office, and it was cool. We go back to the crib, we post up, and it's time for the audition. So Nicole, his girlfriend at the time, and now his wife, by the way, Aubrey's my college roommate, so he was up there already. So Nicole says, all right, Jay, well, you got to go get in line. What time is audition? I'm like 12, so I'll probably get out there like 11. So I'm early. She was like, clearly you don't know what's going on. You need to get out there at 5 a.m. I'm like, 5 a.m? What you talking about? So I go, I catch a dollar cab to a train. A train, when I get out of my exit, she taught me how to get on the train. So I get on the train, I get on the exit. Totally crazy. When I get on the train, I saw my first like train fight in New York. Like some woman was standing there and I guess some guy touched her and she just started punching him. Que te pasa? Que te pasa? Que te pasa? And she was just like killing him. It was crazy. I'm like, yo, this is nuts. I cannot live in this place. What is this crazy place, New York? I get off the train, it's kind of dark outside still, and I'm standing in front of the address and I don't see anybody there. I stand up for like 45 minutes and then some guy's like, yo, bro, are you here for the audition? I'm like, yeah. He's like, it's a block over. I walk a block over and I swear it was a sea of people. Like, it looked like Goombay. It looked like Carnival. It was just people. It was just a mass. It was like this organism of waving musicians and people trying to get on. So I stood in line quite literally from about 5 a.m, maybe 5:15. I don't think I touched the keyboard for the first time till 2. And Nicole packed me this beautiful snack pack. It had like 2 bottles of water, peanuts, raisins, and a sandwich. That was my snack pack. So I had my little snack pack so I didn't have to get out of line because I was hungry. And I stood in line and played. And I think I played, when I got to making this band, it was like Nissan and a few other people. And I played some little song in A-flat. And they said, you're cool for the next round. That was it.
Love
it. Was crazy. It was crazy. That was so crazy.
No, but you know what? I auditioned for the Dreamgirls movie. A lot of people don't.
Really? That's dope.
I auditioned to be Effie because when I was in singing competitions, I always sang "And I Am Telling You," and the auditions were in Chicago, and I live in Chicago.
Are you serious?
So they were like, "Renee, you're not doing anything else. You could just gone over there." And so,
okay, hold up, I'm gonna give you A major because I know that. That's
no, I'm not singing today. No,
I need "And I Am Telling You." I need you. I need you to do that for me. Come on, give it to me one time.
Singing today. I'm not singing.
Oh, Doc, I had no idea you were a singer.
So
like that.
I went and I did that. And actually, it was funny. I'm standing outside of the thing and I hear these people singing and I go, what am I doing here? Why am I here? And then it was like pointless for me to leave. So I was like, oh, you're here. And actually, I think you're called my mom and she's like, you done got up and went. You might as well just. I said, you're right.
Just do it. Just do
so
it.
So I went in there and I did. I did the beginning of, you know, Hold On in Vogue. When you know what I'm talking about.
No, do it for what was it? Again?
Was it? You know what I'm talking about.
One more time for me. I forgot that part. Tell me. Come on, one more time. Just tell me.
I can't sing right now.
I tried, y'all.
He tried. But I did that. And I came out and I couldn't believe it. These girls were like, oh my God, you sound so good. Oh my, I was like, really? Oh, thank you.
You never know what you got till you put it out there.
Well, I mean, it's like I said, I sang in competition and I won awards, but still I was like, but it was cool. And my cousin, she was my choir director, so she helped me get ready for it. And I had
isn't it crazy how sometimes we're our worst critics?
Oh no, I am. I told Cassandra, I tell everyone, I talked myself out of the Ask Dr. Renee show. How many episodes later?
Wow.
I literally said, this is a bad idea, but let me just email 5 people because I had a meeting with a production company and they said, what if we asked your Q score, what would it be? And I looked at her and she goes, you don't know what that is. I go, no, I don't know what that is. She said, so if we asked 100 people who you were, would they know who you were? And I was like, no, show them your picture. I was like, oh. So I said, well, if I do this show on Google Hangouts and I invite some of my friends happen to be celebrities. And I was like, I invite my friends and they share with their audiences, then maybe I'll have these people don't know. Right. Nice. So I invited 5 people. And every one of them said yes. I go, oh, shoot, this means I really have to do this.
You got
to
do it now.
And so that was 2014. And so here we are.
That's beautiful, though. Yeah. It's just it's so small. A seed is so small. But if planted and taken care of, it'll grow. And I'm sure so many people have messaged you about how your life, your little, I don't know if I should project has changed their life.
Yeah. So. And a lot of people are like, how do you do that? I just went and did it. And you watch the old episodes, you guys can see I didn't have such nice camera. This is actually a small background. I have an actual 8x8 step and repeat that I usually sit in front of when I'm in my studio. And, so I just had the little, I've been in Ebony magazine. So the Ebony was on the wall and that was what was behind me. So you could see that,
nice.
And, you know,
nice.
So I started small and then we've grown a little bit and we've got a few more toys, you know, because we can afford a little toys now. But, you know, you got to start
like
somewhere,
that.
Right?
I like that. Everybody's got to start somewhere. The key is to just get started, everybody.
Exactly.
Just get started.
I keep telling people, done is better than perfection.
Yes, it is. And I'm telling you, if you release your product and it's perfect, you released it way too late. You got to have a version 1, version 2, version 3, version 4. They're still making iPhones. Come on.
That's a good point. That is a good point.
I'm telling you, they're going to keep making them every year because if you release it and it's perfect, you release way too late. Go ahead and put yourself out there. Put your thought out there. Put your imagination out there, everybody, because that's really you. When you start talking about the fact that you're fearful about leaving engineering or you're fearful about starting a show or, you know, yeah, you're scared, but go. It's only courage if you are scared.
And, you know, a lot of people are like, but no one's going to watch. I tell this story all the time. My mentor, Paul Carrick Brunson, he did YouTube as well. He said he knew who watched. It was his mother and his brother. And he said, those are the only people. And then one day, the Oprah Winfrey Network called. Because somebody watched and told Oprah. He didn't have a whole lot of viewers, but the right people watched.
I'm telling you, and it can happen just like that. You just never know. I'm so thoughtful. What's the young lady, the poet on inauguration?
Amanda Gorman.
We didn't know who she was yesterday.
And now her book flew up on Amazon. She got a she has a deal with one of the big agencies, ICM, I believe. And she was in a United Way commercial the other night. I was watching.
Just think about it. She's been saying
and
those
poems. She's
going to
be in Super Bowl.
Thank you. She's been saying those poems forever in obscurity on the backside of the mountain, as some might say. But all it takes is one person, one time, one moment. And once that moment occurs, by God, the floodgates open up.
The only thing is that my other mentor, Miss Winfrey, whose birthday was yesterday. I hope you all saw my little tribute on Instagram.
I did. I saw that.
You checked out. We've actually had two videos. There's two videos of me and Oprah on my channel. But she said there's no such thing as luck. It's when opportunity meets
Preparation.
And so that was Amanda. She was ready. And that's the thing. You always have to stay ready.
Always.
Stay ready.
Always. Always do what you're supposed to be doing. Because if you do what you're doing, you don't have to change up when somebody finds you.
Yeah,
so you keep on doing it.
I got a call. It was some obscure hour because I was in California. We had just landed. I want to say it was like 4 o'clock in the morning. Four plus that seven. That makes sense. Sway in the morning. Can you be on? When? In an hour. What? Like, literally, we just landed at 2 a.m.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Okay. I sure will. So I went and took a nap. I woke up and was like, because, you have that morning. And I'm like, okay, let me get my voice right. I got my computer set up. So I can look up what they were talking about. And away we went.
Yes.
And nobody knew that I literally just got the phone call.
Just a minute ago. That's preparation.
And
that's the beauty of it.
And then I told her, I go, I'm in LA. She goes, oh my God, what time is it? I was like, exactly. So, you got to be ready. If you stay ready, you don't have to get ready. And I'm trying to keep you ready so you don't have to get ready.
Of course.
And when I'm ready to roll, you can roll right with me. So. So, Jay, I know that you decided to be a musician full time, but you also were a husband and a new father.
Yes. Yes. So, terrifying, isn't it?
Yes.
A musician, husband, father. That's terrifying. Shout out to every musician as a husband and father. I think a lot of people have musical talent. The funny thing about being a musician, you'll be playing a gig and some guy walks up and he says, oh, I'm a guitar player too. And you're going, not quite, bro. You're not quite. You know, so I'm like, really, what do you play? Oh, just home now. I'm a doctor. Oh, man, you're not a guitar player. You're a doctor. And the difference is, I always think about it from a perspective of breakfast. Like the pig gave his life for breakfast. The chicken just kind of gave a little something. To be a musician and to be a father and to be a husband, it's terrifying to put those things together. Because as a musician, there is no certainty in income. Let me just tell you, there's no certainty. You have a talent, but someone's got to book you to do it. And if they book you, they have to book you instead of the other people. And then they have to pay you, hopefully. And then you have to do a good job, good enough so that they feel like they should book you again. And it's tough. If you meet a musician, give them a dollar. You know what I'm saying? Because it's just difficult to do. At any level of the game, it just never stops, never relents. That's why when people hit a certain point, they just aim for the door. They just get out. You know what I'm saying? Because it's a tough game. And there I was as a musician and a father and a husband, terrified. Some months were fantastic. Oh, man, I played nonstop. Some months were just as dry as an old dog bone, just as dry. Can't find a gig. You couldn't hit a gig with a truck. You just couldn't find one. No one was playing. And can you imagine being a musician during Corona? You remember that bar that you love to go to where the guy who's singing? Well, that guy can't play anywhere. And it just dries up. I found myself looking for more in music. I traveled as a musician, traveled to other continents, played for artists, produced for artists in and out of studios, New York and Atlanta and Los Angeles and Arizona and Chicago and in and out of studios and stuff like that. And musicians know you, you know what I'm saying? You were on TV shows as a musician and people respect what you do. But there was a part of me where there was still like an emptiness there because there wasn't a certainty. And when I looked at my mother-in-law, when I looked at my wife, when I looked at my father-in-law, I could still kind of see that they were like, man, this guy's got to turn the corner with this. It's kind of tough,
He's got my child.
I'm telling you, you can feel it, right? You can feel it. Hey, Ma, hey, Dad, how you guys doing? They're like, how y'all doing? You know, we doing okay, you know, doing all right, you know. It's difficult. It's noble. It's great work, you know, but I can see how you end up being a postal working keyboard player, because keyboard and musician, while it's a fantastic girlfriend, I think it makes a horrible wife. You just, once you marry that thing, it just gets really difficult. And it was tough there for a long time. What happened in, that changed my life is I grew in music. I think locally I probably got as good as it can get. Maybe I'm making $100,000, $110,000 a year as a musician. And it's not bad. It's great money. I'm working like a dog, though. I haven't seen any of my family on any Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or Sunday at all. Like, by the time Wednesday night hits, it's showtime, because as a musician, you work while everyone else is partying. So every party you can imagine, every bar mitzvah, every double mazinka, every room, sacred or secular, every revival, every tent revival, every grand opening of a restaurant, every retirement party, every anniversary, every I'm getting divorced, every girl's night in, every event that you can imagine, I have played those things. And we would just do it nonstop. So I basically like kiss my wife on Thursday and just see her Monday. You know what I'm saying? Because you had to be all around town. I lived for years of my life with my keyboard and amp, a black suit, white shirt, black tie, black shoes in my trunk. Like, because at any point in time, you can be out with the family at a restaurant and someone say, hey, OJ, you free? And you're like, oh, what's the gig? Oh, we got to play Mar-a-Lago from 8 to 12. We got the lobby. Okay, let me go make 450. You know what I'm saying? And you got to go do it. I'm so glad that that time is over. Thank God that stuff is over, because it's a young man's game. I'm not jumping in and out of these venues no more. Come on. No.
So, Jay, we have to, you know, I got a message just now. Somebody, is he going to talk? Yes. So, Jay,
is he going to talk about trade?
Exactly. So
this
I'm
is
sure
the trade.
You all talk, right. That's the trade. The trade is that he has given up his, he earned money instead of giving up his time. And that was a bad trade that he was doing before. And
that's
now
right.
He can play when he wants to, you know? So.
And that's a happier song.
And that is much happier. Much
it's a happier. Song.
So the way that I met Jay is that my Queen of the Money team, Cassandra Cummings, had a great stock success circle. Every Wednesday we meet on Zoom and we're learning about stocks. And she wanted to introduce us to somebody who had taken her options class. So Draka joins us and tells us all about the options class and how we can get our 500 to 5,000 and how she did it in 3 weeks. And I'm over there like, oh, I'm signing up. I can't wait. And then she asked Draka about trading. And I'm like, and I'm half paying attention because I'm already signing up for Build-A-Bank. So I'm like, I'm good. And she said, all I know is the girl said her goal was to make $1,500 a month. I was like, did she say, I mean, $1,500 a day. I said, did she say $1,500 a day? I'm doing quick math like, oh, that would be really good.
That's pretty good.
Right. So then I said, let me listen to what this girl has to say. And she's like, this, you know, my teacher, Jay, and he's this, and he's great. And, you know, he's having a discount right now. And I'm like, wait, what? And so I'm just like, oh, I'm going to sign soon as she get done. And then I go, are you crazy? You sign up right now. The girl lady didn't finish off the screen. I'm typing in the website. What? I was like, okay, did that. And then I found her on Instagram and sent her a message. Hi, I just heard you and I signed up. I know she regrets the day she responded, bless her heart. But and then fast forward when you had Kali, give her testimonial and she's yes. West Indian. We're West Indian. I told my sister, I go, that lady's West Indian. And I found her on Instagram and was like, hi, I'm in the class. I took the course. You know, I bought the course. She's like, oh, sis, you can do it. And so many a times I was like, no, I cannot do this. I was like, I'm not made for this. I can't get it. It's just not for me. And I would send them a message and they were like, no, you can. And I'm thinking, these ladies don't know me. No, I cannot.
Of course you can.
Of course I can. So thousands of dollars later, yes, I can. And and I'm so grateful that I I paid attention to Cassandra, the Stocks and Stilettos, Cassandra, the, you know, and Draca. So you must tell people, how did you fall into trading? And first, you know what? Because people could think that we're trading, like, because actually someone said, I bet you'll talk about GameStop. And I go, that's not the kind of trading he does. So first, explain what it is we do.
What it is we do. So we participate in a market called the futures market. Particularly, the future that we love to trade is a 30-year treasury bond futures. So imagine a market like your grocery market. You have many sections. You have the dairy, and you have produce, and you have the pharmacy, and you have the deli. So the market is just that way. You have all these different types of things that you can participate in the financial markets. Well, we go to the futures section. So think of it like going to produce. But if you go to produce, you can get anything out of produce. So you have to say, well, I want a tomato from the produce section. So you have to think, I want the treasury bonds out of the futures section. All right. So what the futures market is basically like an auction. You can think of it that way. And people, participants in the market, bid the price up and down. You can think of it that way. And all we're doing all day is esteeming value to an asset. How valuable is this thing? You know, just that's all. It's a conversation about value between buyers and sellers. And so it's a really simple game. And I know everybody's like GameStop and all this stuff is going to, I don't go to that section of the market. We let those people have the stocks. I don't do it. Too much homework, too much foolishness, too much manipulation. I'm going right over here with the steak and potatoes, you know, just the simple stuff. Let me get my simple stuff. Let me get my treasury bonds. So yeah, that's what I trade.
And so you guys, my favorite explanation he gave, because I'm black, he black, and I know some of the people watching are black, some aren't, but most of them are. He said, if you're watching a dice game and you don't have any dice in the game, but you saying that so-and-so gonna win, that's what we do. We sit there, we watch the candles, and we say, okay, I think that the buyers are gonna win, I'm gonna buy. And I think the sellers are gonna win, I'm gonna sell. And literally, that's what we do. And literally, Jay, how long do you sit at the computer?
Well, I'm there from 8:20 a.m. usually till about 10:30 a.m. Eastern time daily. I try and stay there that entire time for everyone else's benefit. If you are playing this game by yourself, it is quite literally you can sit down, make your money, and get up. It's really not difficult.
You don't even have to sit there that long. I made in 30 minutes the other day. I made $600, and that was with two contracts. Imagine if it was 6, 7, 8, 10, 20 contracts. And I was like, this is done. This is it, you know. And, Cassandra actually is closing enrollment for her Build-A-Bag class tomorrow. But options, I made 700 that same day. So 1,300 literally between 9:30 a.m. and 10 a.m. And I was done for the day. So
easy.
So Draca, who is my money coach, who will be on the show next week. But Draca said 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and we're done. We're done.
That's it. It doesn't take a long time.
And so what could you do with your time if you made all the money you needed to make in a week in a day?
What would you do?
What would you do with your time? So now Jay has 4 daughters, 3 at home. And he has a lovely wife who I'm sure he does not go and check in with anyone and punch a clock anywhere.
No.
And he has a lovely home in Miami.
Yes.
And he has his time. But he also has all his bills paid. And as he says, the people at the bank say, hi, Mr. Sweeting, what can we do for you?
When I walk in, they call me Mr. Sweeting these days. It's funny. I'm like, I'm the same guy that was here last year. I was, you know, it's funny what happens when they look at a ATM receipt. People, it's funny.
Exactly.
It's so good though. It's lovely. You know, that's what it's weird that money plays that kind of way into people's psychology. But truthfully, the biggest blessing is not the money. No one gets money so we can stare at it. No one says, I want $1 million and takes $1 million and puts it underneath the bed. Nobody does that. Because we don't want the money. We want what the money gives us. And what the money gives us is choices. Freedom, options. The leverage, options. That's what you want. What dance academy would you let your kid join? You know, where would you travel? What would you, I love that question. It's so poignant. What would you do with the rest of your day if you made all the money you need already? Like, let's just say it's Monday morning, it's 8 o'clock, you make $2,000 in a trade. You used to make $750 a week. You just made $2,000. It's now 9:45. What do you do? How much of an impact can you make in the lives of the people around you? And that's what I love about Dr. Renee. I mean, she made it. I ain't gonna front. Her friends are her friends, and her friends are dope. She's got some good ones. Her mentors are her mentors, and her mentors are dope. She's got some good ones. Her education is crazy, and she's got some good education. And her coins are real, so she ain't struggling. But what could you do with the rest of the time? And she says, you know what? I'll be a bridge. I'll take the people I know and introduce them to some other people that I know, and I'll sit here and I'll show people what is happening in my life. That's the biggest thing right there. If you can be what other people need, if you can pair people and connect, man, that's huge right there. That's so dope what you're doing. So dope.
But I mean, the same with you. And that's why I think I clicked with you, because I try to explain to people every time. And I mean, the people who I have, if I have told you about Jay the Trader, I must care about you in some way, shape, or form. Or I wouldn't waste my time, because people keep saying, Renee, are you getting commission? I'm not receiving anybody's commission. I'm getting blessings from the Lord. And look, and I appreciate those. I need all the blessings I can get from the Lord. But I just want everyone to win. If you don't know, my hashtag is live life you deserve. I really clearly do want everyone to live the life they deserve. Yes. I want everyone to win. I do not want to be the only person up on top, because it gets lonely at the top. I want us all to go together. Why not? And we can do so much if we go together. Me and my sister trade together. Me and there's a group of ladies. We in the Queens of Capital, we trade together. I have another group, the Mocha Doc Bullies, we trade together. You know, we can all do this together and help each other.
Yes. Yes. That's the best part. That's the best part. What's better than 1 millionaire, too?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? What's better than me and my family on a vacation? My whole everybody, let's roll. Just imagine the freedom. So that's really what I love. That's what I love to see. P&Ls are cool, but man, when like Kylie gives me a call, or when Drake gives me a call, or when these people give me a call and say, oh, Jay, I just did this. I'm like, what just happened? Like, that is crazy. That is beautiful. Live your life. I love that. Live your life.
You guys, we all do deserve to be happy. We all deserve to be happy. Yes, Ashley, I forgot. Mocha Millionaires, that's our other group. And the Mocha Millionaires are all, they're still all stiletto bullies. So Bomb Bullies is the community. Jay has created this amazing community. Like I said, all these offshoots, Mocha Dog Bullies, Stiletto Bullies. We are all in this together. We are all tackling the market together. You don't have to trade bonds. You don't have to trade futures. But what Jay teaches you, you can trade whatever chart you want to trade. It doesn't matter. It could be the Dow Jones, the NASDAQ, the UB. I mean, it doesn't matter. If you have an internet connection, you have NinjaTrader, and you have a computer, obviously, then you're good. And you can do it anywhere in the world, because Jay's got schools all over the world. Literally. And then the next excuse is, well, I have a day job. No, well, that's okay, because guess what? We trade from 6 p.m. Eastern on Sunday until Friday at 5 p.m. Eastern. There is one hour, Monday through Thursday, that the market closes for maintenance, and that's between 5 and 6. So if you would like to trade for an hour when you get home from work, then that's fine. Or you want to get up in the middle of the night and trade, that's fine. So
you can trade on your lunch break. Yesterday, JD hit me. JD say, hey, bro, I took a 10-minute lunch break and I went and made some money. I think JD made like $279 or $239 or something like that. 10 minutes on a lunch break. She works in a courtroom. Just imagine. So she quite literally cannot have her trading computer open while in that situation. She gets up for lunch, makes a trade, goes back to the courtroom. Crazy. You can get to the bread if you want to get to the bread. My big thing is this, though, Doc. Like, when I look at it, it's like, what you want, you go get. Let's just be honest. You know, if I could just talk to you for a moment, if we're going to be family.
I live in Chicago. The people who stand in line at the Jordan store for the Jordans overnight, not business for what? It's not an appreciating asset.
If you're in Chicago, you stand outside in the cold for popcorn. And I know I did it. I know I was out there for that Garage Mix. Yes, I was. And it was good. But I'm just going to tell you, man, the big thing about it is if you want it, go get it. Don't let anything stand in your way. Speak to yourself. There's been some major vibes on this show already. You know, like the speaking to yourself, the manifesting, the understanding that the power that you have in your tongue about what you, oh, man, I just can't do it because I work. Well, you just told yourself and you heard yourself tell yourself. That's so crazy. Don't create that kind of loop of information and passion in yourself. Make a new loop. I can do this. I'll do it when I get off. I'll do it on my lunch break. I'll do it because I have to. I want to get off this job. Let me tell you something that's funny. Your job will never pay you enough so that you can live in your boss's neighborhood.
Ain't no way.
And what's so crazy is I was talking to Dr. Randy. Do you know that doctors, she told me this, doctors can't own hospitals? Like there's a federal law that says if you're a doctor, you can't own a hospital? Like, because I know in Miami, and rather in the state of Florida, you don't have to be a doctor. You can own a hospital and not be a doctor. So think about what people are trying to do to your time. Just stop for a minute. I know there's a question. Drake, I got you. Just think what people are trying to do to your time. They're trying to capitalize your energy, time, and talent for their gain. That's what a job is. Nothing's wrong with it. Nothing's wrong with your job. Your job is cool. But if you feel like there's more, I'm going to tell you something. There's probably more. And you can get to the more. You can get to it.
JD said she made $452.50.
Oh, sorry, JD. My bad. $452.50. Okay, my bad.
She typed that in for us. But,
how crazy is that?
Right. But Drake, I was getting to that too. So Drake, first of all, Jay has a goal of getting 200,000 students by the summer. Yay! And he's going to get it because I'm going to help him get it. He's going to get it. Yay! Because I don't know anybody in my personal circle that cannot afford to miss out on an opportunity to make more money. I just don't know. I don't know a single soul.
Right,
and I actually do know several millionaires, but I know that even they could stand to make some extra money. I'm telling you.
I'm telling you because it's a beautiful skill. A beautiful skill.
So I know, Jay, I know, but please tell the people, how does it feel to have changed as many lives as you have? Drake, me, my sister, I mean, you know, Dennis. I mean, there's the list goes on and on. Lamar, the list goes on and on.
It's unbelievable. Me and my wife were talking about it today. We took the girls out because we hadn't really spent any time. I've been working all week. We took the girls out and we had, you know, just to have some family time. And we sat back and said, Jesus, you know, like, thank you, God, that your life can matter to someone else. That is big for me. You know what I'm saying? And I can't dwell on it too long because I started thinking about it. And it matters. It matters so much. That's what I can't remember what the word is, but is when you're at a funeral and people are doing there as a neighbor, as a friend, as a teacher to speak well. I think that's what the repast is, or I can't remember what the etymology, but to speak well of someone and to make a positive impact in somebody's life means that when that person goes out and tells somebody about you, they speak well of you. They speak well. Oh, man, I met Draka and Draka did this and she changed my life. You know what I'm saying? That is powerful. And my life is forever changed because now I know I matter. Not because I could jump on a stage and sweat and sing. And I could be a bit, you know, risque with a slow ballad and look at a woman a certain way and create that. That's cool. You know what I'm saying? It's cool to make the crowd move. Yeah, that's dope. It's dope. But like to be able to make a quantitative numerical change in someone's life, like you cannot lie. You didn't know me, now you know me, and now you can quit your job. Like that's crazy for me. I'm still blown away at that. Every P&L that comes in still gets me as excited as the first one that I ever saw. Every time. People think that the bullies love P&L time at 10 a.m. No, it's me. It's my favorite time of day. Favorite time. By far.
P&L is profit and losses. And so at 10 o'clock, most days on Eastern Standard Time, Monday through Friday, Jay says, what's your P&L? And we type them in. And recently he's been posting them to his IG stories, but because he videos them and you just see the money just run. Now, yes, we do lose sometimes. We don't always win. But Jay is really, really, really kind, and it won't last much longer because there's too many of us. But Jay literally will sit there and wait and help you to get in the green, which that's what really turned me on when I got in the training room. I was like, well, Lord, I got to hurry up, because before he decided to change his mind, just in case I need help, I need him to help me out.
We all we got. We all we got. And that's the beautiful thing. Like, and if it's not me, see, what's happening is, I always feel like from a business perspective, you know, I've learned that every company, the ones that are best, they destroy themselves before the competition does. And my job as a leader is not to be, hey, be like me. No, my job is to empower you to be like you. So, Doc, don't front. You know, it's times I'm not around, but you're the one answering questions for the bullies, because you have ascended to a place where now people count on your knowledge and your talent and your skill in the market, your technical and analytical abilities, in order to find out where the money is and where the money resides. You see, so for me, that's the power. The power is not I can teach you. The power is I can make you a teacher, because that's really the juice. I cannot serve 200,000 people. It is quite impossible. But with Doc and with all the rest of the bullies, we could serve some folk now. If I had, you know, just a little bit of help, oh yeah, we could serve these folks. We could change some lives, dude.
Definitely, definitely. So, sure. You guys, I told you we'd give you actionable steps. So, Jay's course is, I'm telling you, is damn near free. I literally, and I'm not joking, my first live trade in 15 minutes paid for the course. Yeah. $350.
How's it? How's it? It's not hard to get to the money. Yeah. And if I could give it away for free, I would. It's just that people.
Just about to say that. We've convinced him to understand that people do not, they don't hold water to anything if it doesn't, it does no value if you don't charge. So people wouldn't get out of the course if he didn't charge. So therefore, he has to charge.
I got to charge you. I hate to because it's sad. But you got to, because people don't understand price and value, Doc. That's all.
They don't. So, and I'm telling you, when you pay for the course, you pay one time for the course, but that one time for the course gets you Sunday training, Tuesday night study sessions with Keisha, better known as CBD Queen.
Yeah.
Then Wednesday evenings, Q&A with whomever would like to get on stage that day to be the person to help us out, bully mentor that night. And whatever extra, because there was a training today. Thank you, Raven Spicy, who did a training today on Market Replay. So there's always these opportunities. And then besides those four those three that I mentioned that are every week, you can get a group together of people and say, hey, let's help each other out. Like I said, I'm in, I don't know how many groups and Slacks on. I'm like, over 2 years ago, I didn't know what Slack was. And then I'm in so many groups on Slack and we help each other. We go on Zoom. I have a Zoom room because I do a lot of Zoom. So I have a Zoom room that I pay for. And I'm like, come on, let's go in and I'll help you. Just, you know, show me your screen and let's go. Or, you know, I will text and bother Drake and be like, help, get me out of here. But, and you know what? We didn't tell you the best part of it. So the next part of it is, Jay, please tell the people, how much money did you have when you started trading?
Zero.
Exactly.
Zip zero. Like, I'm a musician. Y'all didn't hear that part? There's no filling 1K with that keyboard, baby. You don't get that. You know, if you don't play, you don't eat. So quite literally, I was living not even paycheck to paycheck. It was like chill to chill. I couldn't even afford the ECK. It was bad. It was bad. You know, so I started out with absolutely no money. But what happens is you start thinking higher, and if you don't have money, you still have talent. Just think about it. A college recruit coming out of college doesn't have money, but he could throw the ball. So you put him in quarterback. He'll get the money. You know, somebody else can give you some money if you have the talent. And then together, you all can make more. And that's really the model. You know, LeBron could not do anything except play basketball. So they gave him money. He played basketball. And together, the two made more together. And that's exactly what happens when you're a trader. If you don't have the money, you just do what we tell you to do, learn what we tell you to learn, right? You're going to have a lot of mentors around. She mentioned some of them already. You know, it's a whole cast of characters that's dope traders in the bully land. Trust me, you can throw a rock and hit a dope trader. So it's a whole lot of them. Listen to what they say, learn the course. Now you got the information. Well, don't worry about the money, because if you are good, the money will find you, right? Exactly. So I started with this thing they call a combine. It's like a trader test. You take the test. If you pass the test, they give you the money. Now, I know this sounds like a foreign concept, but if you think about all major investors out here, they're not trading their money. They're not investing their money. And let me just tell you, investing and trading is kind of like two different things, but they're cousins. Right? You buy something low, you want to sell it high. Same thing with trading, except we buy low, sell high, or we sell high and buy low. I know everybody kind of understands that now that the GameStop thing is going on, but like that's so we can do it too. It's very easy to do. And all of these folks that you see with all of these billions and trillions of dollars in assets under management, they're trading other people's money. And you, at your house, you don't have to liquidate your credit card. You don't have to put your bank account up. You don't have to take out a second mortgage on your house in order to find the money to trade with. There are no minimum rules for the 25K minimum. No, no, no. Somebody else will give you the money back. They'll give you the money now.
And so when I first heard that, I was like, huh? But you guys, it's an 80-20 split. We keep 80. They take 20. So becoming a funded trader, 80% is not shabby considering I don't have to put up my money.
I have no skin in the game other than my talent.
I have no skin in the game but my talent.
That's it.
And I really don't think people are hearing us. So you take the course, which is a video course. So it's videos. You do it at your own pace because I know you got a crazy work schedule. You got 10 kids. You got crazy husband, crazy boy. I understand. You take it at your own pace. Watch the videos at your own pace. We're always going to be here. You can ask us questions all night and day in Slack, and somebody will answer them, because I promise you somebody is up. Somebody's probably trading. So please just ask the questions, whatever the questions may be. No questions is a stupid question.
None, ever.
Ask the questions. But the classes, the courses are literally videos you watch of Jay, and I'm telling you, gives you the information, and he gives it so simply that you will understand it. You don't have to be a doctor, engineer, et cetera. He has people of all walks of life that do this. People that went to higher education and those that did not.
Now, we can call it what they are. It's all kinds of bullies. Some of them rode the short bus. It's all right. They're the short bus bullies. No, I'm just playing. You know, everybody has a different skill set.
Exactly.
But what I love to say, Doc, is that we're all traders.
We're all traders.
Everybody is a trader. You're always in a trade, no matter what you say. You're in a trade right now. You're watching us. We're giving you information in exchange for your time.
Yeah.
That's a trade. And you're always in a trade. Everybody has been a trader before, and everybody understands value. You ever scroll through on your timeline? All that is voting for value. You stop at a post that is worth your time.
Yes.
You voted. You gave your time to that post. Well, Instagram says, hey, you're watching this. This must be important. And the algorithm votes that post up a little bit higher. That's why you need to make sure you hit like, share, and subscribe right now.
Thank you.
Appreciate that. Dr. Renee is right here giving a game away. Literally juice. You feel me? Like real live juice that you need for your actual life. Yeah, everybody know what's going down with Tip and Tiny. Everybody know what's going on with this one and that one. Everybody talking about GameStop and this. Hey, let me tell you what Doc is doing. Doc is bringing titans. Like, to be counted among the people that she has brought on this show is like, Cassandra, are you serious? Come on now. Draco next week, are you serious? Come on now. Past guests, celebrity folks who run, they queue for real high. Don't nobody know OJ. I'm just grateful that she brought me here. I'm going to tell you what you do. Literally right now, like, comment, share, subscribe. Everybody type that. Type like, then type comment, then type share, then type subscribe. Come on, don't quit on me now. No, don't quit now. You all, yeah, everybody want to know about trading. This is the trade. Because what we're asking you to do is trade the knowledge you possess and give it to someone else. The trade is going to be you being nice to someone. Guess what you get back? You can't plant a seed in somebody else's life without that seed growing. And who do you think eats from that tree? Even if your jaws won't get it, guess who might get it? Your kids might. You nice to somebody today, and that person might be nice to your son tomorrow, might be nice to your daughter tomorrow. You cannot plant a seed and it does not grow. Share. That and then, is the responsibility.
So, you know, we have to add, Jay has taught a 13-year-old who is changing the trajectory of his entire life and his family's, because we did tell you how much money you can make, right? There's no limit on how much money you can make.
It's crazy.
Yeah, 13. And then I love the story about Chandler. Chandler took the course last summer and went to his senior year of high school. I swear he went six figures deep. I promise you. The man was funded too, right?
Chandler put up his own bread. Chandler didn't take a combine. So he started with a $3,000 account. His parents gave him $1,500. He told his dad, he said, "Dad, I have $1,500. Will you match me?" So he started a brokerage account with $3,000. $3,000 is about six contracts a trade. And he dynamically scaled up. I think Chandler right now is maybe a 20 contract trader. Last I checked on him was August. And he was somewhere around $84,000.
See?
So he took a class in May or June or something like that. Yeah. Started in June, and by August, he was somewhere just shy of 100. He should probably be at like 150, 160 right now. If I checked on him, I got to check on him.
Yeah. So I'm telling you, the man, he is a really good teacher, you guys. He's a great teacher. I'm telling you, great teacher. And then the community that he has created is just so amazing.
Thank you so much.
No, it's the truth. But I have to tell you a funny. So Jay always says he has all sorts of people in his class. He got doctors, he got lawyers, he has actors, there's producers, you know, et cetera, right? Mm-hmm. So then he says, so Tamika Dixon, I want to say thank you because she did super chat today and gave some money. So I appreciate you because you guys know I do this show for free. So I do appreciate the super chats, even if it's a dollar to it, all that adds up and I appreciate it. So Tamika comes in and says something, and Jake's like, you know, that's a NBA ring. What I mean, and I was like, what did he say? And then he goes, and then I think she corrected him, said, no, I have two. And I'm like, so I was like, wait a minute, what her name's on the screen? So I Googled it. I don't know sports. Alicia's actually a basketball player. I'm not a sports person. So I Google it and I go, oh my God, that's her. So I text Alicia and I said, Alicia, she's in the course. She was on the Zoom this morning.
Yes.
Alicia's like, oh my God, WNBA. Wow.
I always say, get to know a bully. I haven't met a bad bully yet. The bomb bullies are great, great people.
And she was right there helping somebody that morning. That's why she came on camera. She was helping someone. I'm telling you, it's the most amazing community. We all are trying to help each other to get to the, we just all trying to get with the same place. We all trying to just make sure we get the money. That's all.
Get to the bag. I mean, and it's fantastic. There's so many wonderful stories inside of the community. So many beneficial things. See, we joke and we laugh. We argue about who might be the best at basketball or best at football or who's got the best cookies or anything, you know, but the truth of the matter is it is just the coming together of people. It is community. That's what it is.
And
it
that's
is
where we all we got came from, right?
We all we got. And that's fine because we all we need. Trust me. All you got is all you ever going to need right now, where you are in life to get to where you want to go. Just use what's around you. Just use what you got right now. Right now you can use it. You don't have to wait. You don't need anything else. You're already pretty enough, handsome enough. You're already smart enough. You're already witty enough. You're already talented enough. You're already hardworking enough. You're already patient enough. You're already disciplined enough. Get to it. The biggest thing, the best seed you can plant. I mean, it blows my mind. You remember when Apple was doing the split? I've never been so frustrated in my life when Apple did the split. Because here were so many people that were so willing to hand their money to someone else. The most damaging, they call this conversion rates, right? So I'm sure you know this. So everybody listen, this is what's crazy. The craziest thing about my business and what I know about people is out of every 10 people that come to my site, one person purchases. Most people will say, well, Jay, you have a great conversion ratio. That's 10%. I'm not thinking about it that way, though. What I'm thinking is I've set up something that I know is good, that is chucked full of proof, and only nine people won't believe that they can do it. Only one believe that they will. And that is scary. We have got to change that dynamic. We've got to, people. Like your niece, nephew, sister, brother, they got to see you achieve. Because then they'll say, shoot, if they did it, I know I could do it.
Exactly. And that's why, I do a lot of mentoring, and that's the thing. I just want to expose you to, and I see Glenda Gill is on here. I am a mentor with Save a Girl, Save a World. That's her organization. We do high school girls and college girls. And I want to show them that this is possible. So therefore they know that they can do it. Because I look just like you. And we can, if I could do it, then, you know, you could do it. And I was a Girl Scout leader for several years. I still am very active with the Girl Scouts. Nice. I wanted to show those little girls, if I can do it, you can do it. There's nothing special about me. I worked really hard, and that's how I was able to get it done. And so I think that's so important. Jay is having a conference this year, you guys, the first ever Bombily conferences this year. And it's all about generational wealth, because that's what we're trying to create, is generational wealth. So Draka and I, well, Draka will be on next week and she'll talk about it. But as you guys know, last week I spoke with Cassandra. We trade and we use that money to purchase long-term options for our long-term investments. That is what's going to pay us way long and long, and then pay our children and their children and stuff. So that's how we're creating this. That's how we're doing it all. Okay.
Yeah.
So I want you to please talk about the conference. I am so excited. We cannot wait.
The conference is going to be so dope. Everybody come here, come close. Don't tell nobody this. Shh. Don't tell nobody. It's a secret. It's between me and you. You ready? You should come to the conference.
So we'll have the link in the box below about the conference. It's in August. It's going to be in Miami.
Yeah.
If you've ever stayed at Intercontinental, you know that they're fabulous. There's an Oprah Winfrey cover, and she's standing at the Intercontinental in Chicago. I can't remember what month, what year, but it was beautiful. And I've actually been lucky enough to stay at that Intercontinental. And obviously, because I walk a lot in Chicago, I've walked past it many a times. But I'm really excited. I've never really hung out in Miami. We took a cruise from Miami, and we've just passed through. But I passed through in the airport, but I've never actually hung out in Miami. So I'm really excited about that.
Is that Intercontinental is right on Biscayne. So when you went out on your cruise, you took the causeway out, and then you went out to the port of Miami, you know. So right away from the port, come to the American Airlines, the next big building, that's the Intercontinental, right by the bay. City view is going to be amazing. You can see the A1A out your window, the cars going back and forth. You have the museum that's there, the Frost Museum, and other wonderful things. You know, you're a stone's throw away from all of the amphitheaters. Then you can catch a quick Uber or something like that. You can be in Wynwood in 10 minutes. You can be in South Beach in 15 minutes. Man, in this bully conference, the idea behind it is, just imagine you do have one seed. It's a good seed. You can change the world with a seed. And I believe that God has planted us in our families as seeds to change our families, right? You can change the lives of those that came before you, and you can definitely change the lives of those that came after you. And as traders, you understand the money so quick. It's so quick. It's so quick, especially once you get the skill down. You know, you put in a little bit of work, you practice, but the money's so quick, so you end up making $600, $700, $800, $900 a day, which is really fantastic money if you think about the rest of the world, right? If you think about the rest of your city, it's great money. You know what I'm saying? So you're making all that money, but the idea is, how do we multiply that gift for generational wealth? Glenda Gill, what's up? I see you.
So that is what I was telling you. She founded Save a Girl, Save a World. She's a fellow Detroiter, and she is willing to, she's going to take the class, and she's going to pay for one of the girls to take it.
Oh, wonderful. Well, if you get a girl, then I want to pay for a young lady to take the course as well.
Glenda. We got Jay's going to do one too.
A high school student.
We're in Clark, Atlanta, and we have high school students as well.
I need that. So, Glenda, I will get with Dr. Renee or something like that, and you find out which one of the young ladies that's eligible, and we will make sure that they get into the class, and it'll be fantastic. That's beautiful. Let's go change some lives. Yeah.
And I mean, I'm telling you, that's what this is about. At Christmas time, you guys, we did a whole week of giving. We're trying to do even more giving throughout the year. Jay does have free classes every Sunday and Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
And he does webinars with Webinar Jam. And it's a lovely introductory. I'm telling you, when you learn that one trade, you're going to want to know, wait a minute, how do I get for the money? Taste is just, oh my God, it's going to make you crazy. When you see how, because he said, look, he just said Chandler trades 20 contracts. You guys, that little 600 I made, 300 times 20, last I checked was $6,000.
Last I checked, it was 6 racks in your face.
In 30 minutes.
This is an 18-year-old kid that's still in 12th grade sitting in history class that's making $6,000 and $7,000 a day.
You guys, a day.
That's what he's doing every day. And the young man is talented. Shout out to Chandler. Shout out to the Dallas-Fort Worth District of Schools that allow him to come to school later. I told Chandler, I say, man, it's like your school should kind of acquiesce. They should bend to this because it's almost like you like Justin Bieber or something like that. It's no kids like you in the nation. And thank God that his principal, they say, well, you don't have to come to high school in the morning like the rest of the students. You don't have to come until 11:30. So they let him trade in the morning. And then, yeah, we had to speak. His mom and dad, they spoke to the principal, told him what was going on in Chandler's life, how much of a phenom he is when it comes down to market activity. And this principal said, well, don't come at 7:30. Chandler doesn't have to go to school till 11:30. Yeah.
Wow. I didn't know that. That is awesome.
Super strong.
So, you guys, first of all, thank you, Jay. Jay, I'm going to have, I think the link is already in the box below on YouTube, but you guys, if you're watching anywhere else, one, the video will only be live on, it'll only stay available on YouTube. It's going to be deleted on all the other platforms. So you need to come to YouTube. That's where the link will be to the course.
Mm-hmm.
That's where the secret promo code will be also to get you 50% off for the course, because Jay loves us so much that he's like, you know what? I can't charge you that much. I'm going to give you a little discount. So ask Dr. Renee, folks, there'll be a nice little code down there and you guys can get 50% off for the course. Then I'll also have a link for the conference because, of course, you want to make sure that you are in Miami. And once you make all this bread, it'll be no big deal for you to get to Miami. Trust and believe. Trust and believe.
And it's going to be so much fun. Speakers coming out to talk about e-com and the way that the world is moving when it comes to cannabidiols and the marijuana industry. We have people coming out to talk about your trust, and they're talking about insurance, not that other kind of like real insurance, the kind of senators and judges, the people on the Supreme Court, that their kind of insurance. So we're going to really be uncovering some heavy duty stuff, and we're going to do it while we're having fun. I mean, I don't know the last time you traded on the beach while the Atlantic was running up against your feet, but you know, we're going to do that. I think that we should. You know, I don't know the last time you was popping bottles on the yacht, but I mean, we're going to do that. So I think you should. I don't know the last time that you hung out with people that inspired you, not just turned you on, not just entertained you. I'm talking about inspiration. Somebody who when they talk, you said, geez, I got to do more. So we're bringing those people in, people who really took one talent and turned it into a 9-figure business, real talk. Those people, that's who we're bringing in. Man, so I'm so excited. Earlier, Doc, there was a message from Draco. Did I miss that? I know.
No, we talked about it. We all we got.
Okay, cool. I wanted to make sure we all we got.
We got it.
Okay, cool. And then I want to say, everybody, you know, we've got to take care of what's ours. Dr. Renee is ours. Just like
and
we
so
have.
So is Jay. So everyone subscribe to his channel too, please. Jay the Trader. Subscribe to his channel. He is live every morning giving the pre-market breakdown. Please subscribe to his channel. We're trying to get his stuff together. Like we got our, I got my stuff together. I'm trying to help him get his stuff together. So please subscribe.
Thank you. I appreciate that. But like I was saying, you know, like Doc is very, very important. And do me a huge favor. Like there's this thing called like a thunderclap. So everybody, you know, when you like, comment and share, like a whole lot of comments do that, you know, after you're done doing that, maybe screenshot it, share it on your Instagram, share it on your other platform, share it on your LinkedIn, you know, because these are our people. You know what I'm saying? We want to celebrate our folks. We want to be there for our folks. That's really big for me right now. That's something I find myself loving more. You know, if your friend is doing something and they started their business, you might not even want a chicken sandwich today. But go by their place and get a chicken sandwich because they started their chicken sandwich business. You know, whatever that they're doing, if they selling jewelry, you know that they got it from Alibaba and they just repackaging it. Go ahead and buy you some repackaged Alibaba jewelry. Do that because it is your friend. That's your people. I'm just going to say a few names. All right. I'm going to say Gail King. That's a good friend. Supported her friend. You know, Rahm Emanuel. That's a good friend. He just supported his friend. You know, it's a whole lot more. Just people who supported their friends and keep supporting your friends. Dr. Renee is a friend. You know, so let's just make sure that we do that and do it all around. You understand? Let's do it.
I appreciate it. So you guys, thank you so much. We didn't have any questions except for the one Draka threw up there. I guess no one else had any questions. I guess we explained it very well, how you get to this money.
Yes.
I hope you all will be getting to the money. There is, for those Detroiters that are watching, because we are from the Detroit, there is a Detroit Bully channel. It's kind of quiet, so maybe some of you Detroiters will come in and it'll get some noise going. But but we want everyone to win. We just want everyone to win. And we can all do this. You know, honestly, somebody said we could be the next Wall Street Bets. We probably could. Very easily.
Yes.
Very easily. Now,
Yes, we could. There is nothing that is impossible to people if they work together. I'll leave you with a story about what it means to have a community. The word community, com, right? That means with. That's a prefix meaning with, in unity. So with union, with togetherness, right? So imagine not just people gather, but a community, people who are together. There's a story about people who decided that they would build something to go up to God. It's called the story of the Tower of Babel. It is while we say the word to babble on. You're babbling. Right. If you ever heard someone use that word, it comes from the Tower of Babel. That story is when people were together, they all agreed that they would build a tower and it would go to heaven. According to my faith tradition, God himself said, hey, they're going to make it. That's the coolest part of the story. It wasn't the fact that they said that they were going to agree. It wasn't the fact that they started. It was the fact that God himself, a God who I believe is immutable, who cannot lie, literally said, these people that I created are powerful enough that if I don't do something, next thing you know, I'll have neighbors. He had to confuse their language so that when one asked for something, the other did not understand what was being required or asked of him. Now, think about the power of that. And all that was a few people inside of Wall Street Bets, and they got Wall Street running scared. They got them breaking the rules, and it wasn't even everybody. It was a couple people. Imagine what can happen in the NBA, the NFL, the entertainment industry, online. What can happen with Facebook? What would happen with anything? Just what happens when you decide to get together? And I'm going to tell you, it don't take a lot. Imagine if you and your sister decided that y'all was going to save your family. Imagine if you and your spouse decided that anybody else that comes from us will never have to struggle the way we did. Just imagine. You are powerful. You can do this if you want to.
Yeah, you can do it. I'm telling you, you can do it. If I can do it, you can do it. And then next week when you hear Draka's story, you'll be like, oh, Lord, if she can do it, we can do it. Draka has a whole lot on her plate, but she's getting it done. She's getting it done. And she gets it done. So I want everyone to please follow this man. He is J_the_trader on Instagram. And he's on Clubhouse, Jay the Trader. He's Jay the Trader on YouTube.
Everywhere.
Oh, Draka, my sister said Draka, the co-executive producer of the show today, has said that $22 is the deposit for to save your spot for the conference.
Yes.
$22. Like I said, we will get the link and we will post it in the box below, but make sure that you do that. And as Jay always says, if you're not a bully, become a bully. And if you are a bully, you need to go to get to studying. Okay.
It's simple.
So, it's very simple. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jay. This was fabulous. This is more than I ever thought it could be. So thank you so much. And to everyone that's watched, thank you so much. You guys have really, you hung in there because this was long and you guys hung in there. So apparently the information was good. So I appreciate it. We're going to keep bringing it to you. Friday, I just booked a very special guest. It's going to be a Friday night show because it's special. Friday night at 9 o'clock Eastern, we're going to have the Dr. Dre. Now, pause for the cause. The Dr. Dre I am talking about is my bestie, Dr. Dreon Birch. Dr. Dre, in case you didn't hear, was sued by the other Dr. Dre, but my Dr. Dre really is a doctor, and he won the lawsuit because of his fabulous trademark attorney that we both share, praise the Lord. And so I cannot wait to have him. You guys, he has come out with his own condom and lube line. This is just a sneak peek, Momentum. And nice. He is the first physician to have an FDA-approved condom. And so that's why it's Friday night at 9, and February being the month of love. So hopefully we can have some candid conversation and help some couples and some single people and whatever, but you can learn more about this. So Friday night, 9 p.m., if you would like, if you're grown up, because it's going to be a grown people conversation, grown folks join us 9 p.m. right here, Friday night, February 5th, and then February 6th, we're going to be back to Getting Where the Money Reside, talking to my money coach, Draka Jones, Finance on Fleek. You can find her on everything at Finance on Fleek. She's going to tell us her story, because her story is another amazing, motivating, inspiring story.
Yes.
And she's also going to tell you how she can help you get to the money. Besides being a bully mentor, she is, and Jay will attest to this, she is amazing about helping you figure out your finances and making sure that you got the stuff going in the right place and coming from the right place and saving. And She can, what is it? Squeeze water from a penny, from a turnip. Is that what it is?
I'm telling you, she, one of her dollars act like 10 of yours.
Right.
I don't know how she does it. She knows how to do it though.
Okay. So Jay, you got to close us out with your usual.
Clock on the wall.
Yes, sir.
What? I get to say that on Dr. Renee Show. Oh my goodness. Well, folks, you know how it goes. If you're a bully, you know what I'm saying? Go study. And if not, man, do yourself, do your spouse, do your future a favor. Do your future self a favor, your children. Become one. The clock on the wall says that's about all. We enjoyed y'all and had a ball. Boom, boom, ski, ski. That's it. We got to split. Y'all have a fantastic time.
Peace, everyone. Thank you so much.